Let me, I see a certain question is there. Let me see that. Okay, I will see in the last. Okay. There, someone was asking about the exercises. So in the last, I will tell that we have a mail ID. So we have to please please send their mail, your requirements, everything, and we will surely conduct as per your requirement. So we were talking about the different cybersecurity must-haves. First was the inventory. So I already talked about that. Then we have to make sure that there is controlled use of administrative privileges. So whatever devices we are having, so we must ensure that administrative privileges are given to only few people, and whatever they are doing, it must be recorded, and there are and so an order should be taken that who is using what privilege. And the third point is that secure configuration for hardware and software. So secure configuration is very much important, that whatever devices you are using, that they are properly configured, because if they are not configured properly, then there may be some vulnerabilities and it may be easily exploited. And the patching and update of both hardware and software is done on a periodic basis. Third point is malware defense. So we must have antivirus, anti-malware system installed in our devices, and they are regularly updated. And vulnerability and patch management. So, like we inserting, we issue very, very various vulnerabilities and threat information. So, based on that thing, we have to patch your system accordingly. So, what is cyber resilience? Cyber resilience that how will you behave in a case of cyber incident or the cyber. How you can maintain that? So we can see that there are four basic principles of that: anticipate, withstand, recover, and evolve. So anticipate that you should be able to know that what are the critical threats in your sector. So critical threats and various things like, and then you should be able to withstand. If something happens, you should be able to withstand that and recover easily, means recover fast. And finally, evolve from that. You have to learn from that, whatever the learning were there from past incidents, and so that this in case of future such incidents, no such thing is repeated again. Now we will see that what are the different impacts of a cyber attack. Cyber attacks, mainly there are three phases. Firstly, the hacker will try to penetrate in the system. After penetration, there will be a detection by our means you will detect it, and finally, after detection, you will start a recovery process. So we should there may be four different type of controls in case of cyber resilience. First is that protective control. Protective control is that whatever system you have designed, there are protection initially, so it will increase the work factor for the attacker. So initially, it will be hard for the attacker to enter your system. And the second is the detective controls. The detective controls is that it is detected quite earlier, so there will be a quite rapid response. The third is containment control. The containment control is that it will reduce the impact of the attacker. And the fourth is the recovery control. Recovery control is that it will be recovered quite fast. So if we see that if we apply all four these techniques, then we will see that the attack effect is quite less. Now we will see that in incident prevention. The prevention and precautionary measure, what should be taken? The first is the nomination of a chief information security officer in the organization. Information security, and we can see the different points. Information security policy should have a proper policy as per the guidelines. Then business continuity plan, BCP, disaster recovery plan, security of information infrastructure, network and applications, network traffic scanning. You should scan your traffic. Isolation of critical networks. These are very important. Implementation of security guidelines issued by the concerned authorities. We regularly issue certain guidelines, so you should look at that regular basis. Vendor risk management, supply chain risk management, because these are the newer new vulnerabilities that are coming, because you can make your system very secure, but your vendor who is there, his system is not that secure, or your supply chain who is supplying different goods to your company organization, then that may have vulnerability to in that system. So we have to also ensure that those organizations also are properly patched and have proper security measures in them. Then we can do the background checks so that insider threats are very minimum. Audit and assurance. So you have to get your system audited on a regular basis. Security training and awareness. So this is also very important, because we nowadays we should ensure that the cybersecurity knowledge reaches to the every individual level, so that not a single point of entry should be vulnerable. Coordination of incident and information sharing. So one question was there that they were asking that CCMP is invoked in case of a cyber incident. Not exactly, because it is a comprehensive document which tells about that we have to prepare also. We have to prepare in advance that what could be the security threat in our sector or organization. And we have to predict from the past experiences that these things are very problematic for our organization or sector, and we have to keep proper in place our security things so that those things are not able to keep problem to our system. And so if somehow some incident occurs, then it also includes that what will be your response. So now we look after the cybersecurity assurance level of assurance. So level of assurance is mainly that at what level, what is assurance? Assurance is something in the case of securities that our systems are properly defended, and whatever the minimum criteria are there, we have achieved that. So level one is that organization are aware of their IT security best practices. They know that what are the best practices are. In the level two, we can see that they have implemented those IT practices, what they were learned. And based on those practices, they may have conducted their internal surveys or whatever the compliance they have prepared, they have verified from a third party. Level three is that they have conducted different audit techniques like VAPT, vulnerable assessment, penetration testing of their infrastructure. So from a third party, so they have conducted those IT security posture verification. And the level 3 plus comes where the organization have implemented their own CCMPs. So now the organization have prepared their CCMP, then they can be treated as level 3 plus. And level 4 is that the organizations have the ability, now have the ability to monitor and mitigate the threats and vulnerabilities. Like they have different devices like IPS, intrusion prevention system, intrusion detection systems. So these kind of devices they have in place, so they can now monitor their traffic and try to mitigate the threats and vulnerabilities. Level 4 plus is that now they are collaborating with the different sectors like CERTIN, Sectoral CERTs, ISEX for their threat intelligence. And finally, level 4 plus plus is that now they are able to predict on their whatever the learnings they have. Now they will able to predict that what are the different security risks and attack paths. Crisis recognition, mitigation, and management. See, the different level of crisis can be defined into four levels concerning our country. So level four can be a large scale attack on a single organization. And level two, there are multiple organizations. Level three, organization on a state by state, multiple states. And level four, finally, that is very serious. Cyber attack on infrastructure, on the critical sector, on a government across all the nations.